Now we're ready to light the torch and adjust the flame. We'll start with acetylene as the fuel gas and then move on to alternate fuels. We'll show you how to light a torch with both heating and cutting attachments, as well as how to set a neutral flame and how to shut down the flame. Before you light a torch, be sure you're wearing proper personal protective equipment and always purge the system.
Here I have a torch with a multi-flame heating attachment. Now to light it, I'm going to hold the torch in one hand and a spark lighter in the other. Now before I light the torch, I need to be sure that I'm not aiming the torch in the direction of any people, my equipment, or any flammable materials that may be in the area. I do need to make sure I have the correct shaded lenses on. And now when I light the torch, I'm going to open the fuel valve about an eighth of a turn and ignite the gas. Now I'm going to continue opening the fuel valve until all the smoke and soot disappear. I'll transfer over to the oxygen valve and slowly open it until a bright neutral flame is established.
Now we're going to talk about cutting with alternate fuel. Alternate fuel, some of the gases are heavier than air and some are lighter and they have a tendency to float. So we'll need some different techniques. We'll discuss three of those today. The first one is much like you did with acetylene. I'll turn on the fuel valve about a quarter of a turn, ignite the flame, and then adjust it, add the oxygen slowly, and adjust it to a neutral flame. I can walk this up to heavy heat desired. I'll then shut off the oxygen first and the fuel gas last. You'd use this in most situations. The second one is I will put the torch about a 45 degree angle, ignite the fuel gas, and add the oxygen. You'll hear it snap back into place. That time I'll adjust it to a neutral flame. Now I'd use this in windy conditions, outdoors, or if you have a fan blowing on you. The third way is I'd open both valves about a quarter to a half a turn and ignite the flame. And I can walk it up to the desired heat that's necessary. And you'll notice that the characteristics of this flame is a lot different than the characteristics of acetylene.
This safety item bears repeating. No matter what fuel you use, purge the torch before lighting it.
Now let's discuss shutting down the torch. Regardless of what fuel gas you use, you always want to follow this technique. First, shut down the oxygen and then the fuel valve. By doing this, I'm checking both of my valves every time I shut the torch down. If you get a small flame at the end of the tip, that'll mean that your fuel gas is leaking. If you get a snap or a pop when I shut it down, that'll mean that my oxygen valve is leaking. By shutting off the oxygen first, fuel gas last, I check these valves every time I use the torch. Now it's time to shut down the entire system.
We'll start by closing both cylinder valves.
Once the valves are closed, I then want to release the pressure inside the system. I'll do that by first opening the oxygen valve until the pressure's down, and then the fuel gas valve.
Next, we'll release the tension on the adjusting screws by turning them counterclockwise until they move freely. And we'll check the pressure, making sure there isn't anything indicating in the system.
Always follow the proper shutdown procedures when finished with your work, even if it's just for a lunch break. Never leave oxy-fuel systems pressurized while unattended.